Okay, guys, as you guys already seen, so almost all the sweeps that I do, so I finish the position with the fold in the folding pass. So it's the way that I like to pass. So every time I sweep, I look for finish the position, controlling the guy. Every time I'm one step ahead, it's easier to keep working, and the guy need to open his game to try to defense and then to sweep. So I'm always one step ahead. That's gonna make it easier to work. Okay, I'm gonna give you guys an example. So we're gonna work a sweep and then we're gonna get at the folding pass. Okay, so for example, the first one we did, we were in the knee shield here. And I change the hooks and I get on top like this. Okay, every time I'm here smashing the both legs here, okay, with my belly on his leg over here and controlling his hip, we call it folding pass. So we're gonna start here, we're gonna work a couple different variations from here. So the first one we're gonna work, so I just sweep him, I got this position, okay. The first thing, I'm gonna use my left hand to control his hip, okay? I can control the pants because I already was using this grip, so I can just keep using this grip. And now, what I'm gonna look? My shoulder on his back, okay? It's very important I use my shoulder on his back to try to make him flat on the mat. Okay, guys, so I'm controlling his pants over there, okay? And I'm gonna use my shoulder on his bed. So my shoulder goes on his bed and look, I'm gonna start to make him flat on the mat. And in the same time, I'm gonna be on my toes over here. I don't let my knee on the mat because every time I let my knee on the mat, I'm sharing my weight with the knee and with my shoulder here. So when I'm on my toes, all my weight is on his bed. And then I can use my shoulder pressure really well. So look, my shoulder is on his belly, and look, my both knees are up out the mat, okay? So that we're gonna looking for all the time, okay? This shoulder pressure to put him flat on the mat, okay? From here, okay, I'm gonna start to work controlling this lapel. So I'm gonna control the lapel and I'm gonna put the shoulder pressure, okay? So I'm gonna start to use my shoulder to make him flat on the mat and I'm gonna start to bring my knee between his legs over here. It's really important this leg be close to his leg over here, to his outside leg. Because if I sit like this, if the guy just open the knee, he can sweep or he can go to the knee bar, okay? So I'm gonna keep using my grips and I'm just gonna like using my knee to push his leg. And this hook goes over his shin. Okay, now if he tries to shrimp, I just keep following him. Try to shrimp. Okay, now I have a good control. It's really important. I control first his hip and then try to control his head and put the shoulder pressure. If I get this position and try to control his head, so I don't have any control yet from here, for example, and I try to control his head, if he shrimp and open his knee, ooh, I lose everything. So I don't want it to happen, so I control the pants there, put the shoulder pressure. First thing, I get this control over here, okay, and I put the hook to avoid him to shrimp, okay? I keep grabbing the lapel, okay? Now look, I'm tight, okay? If I try to control his head, it's easier because I'm still controlling his hip. So I have the control of his hip, and now I'm gonna control his head and put the shoulder pressure. So I control his head, okay? First thing, I'm gonna pull him. Once I pull him, I'm gonna put the shoulder pressure. Okay, but it's very important, guys. When I put the shoulder pressure, I need to put the shoulder pressure on his neck and not on his face. Look, when I put on his face, it's a kind of annoying, but the guy, if the guy is a tough guy, doesn't matter, okay? So, once I pull him, I put my shoulder pressure on his neck. So, gonna be like a choke here. The guy can stay here for a long time, so gonna be easier to pass his guard. So I keep using the pressure, and then I just like change my hips a little bit and pass straight to the side control. And then I can just keep going and get a good pressure here. Okay? So again, we're gonna start here. Every time that I have this control over here, we call folding pass, right? So, control his hip. First thing, I need to control his hips, right? So my shoulder goes on his back. And now I'm gonna start to put my shoulder pressure to make him flat on the mat. You guys can see that he's like on his shoulder. When I start to put the pressure, he's gonna be flat on the mat. That we're gonna looking for. So again, control the hips. And now, I'm gonna use my shoulder pressure to make him flat on the mat. And look, I start to bring my knee between his legs. And my hook goes over the shin, over here, okay? My hook over the shin. And now I can just keep controlling. If I have the opportunity, I can just control his head, pull him to me, okay? And now I put the shoulder pressure. I'm gonna control his hip over here. I'm gonna control with the same grip I did in the beginning of the position. I'm gonna keep using that one. I'm here. I'm gonna keep pulling his hip over here. I just switch my base a little bit. And when I switch my base, my shoulder pressure is getting stronger, and then I can pass a guard. Okay? So one more time, I'm gonna do in full speed right now. Here, so it's not that, it's a kind of, I don't need to be fast in the folding pass. Every time I'm here, I just need to be tight, I don't need to be fast. So the full speed is not gonna be like full speed, okay? I'm gonna be like slowly, but I need to keep the pressure all the time. So again, control the hips, put the shoulder pressure on his back, bring my knee between his legs, okay? At the same time, I'm gonna look for the hook around his shin, okay? And then I control the head, pull him to me, and then I can back up.